In this video, I'm going to explain to you a little about custom control layers. Sometimes it can seem that custom controls are not a very easy task to do, but if you are clear with the basic concepts, then it will be much easier. In this video, we're going to discuss the layers of custom controls, which are the pillars of any customization. Before going directly into the layers, let's first discuss what is a custom control. Well, sometimes Tosca is not able to recognize, identify, or steer certain controls as per the business requirements. So in this scenario, we need to modify the steering behavior of Tosca to steer the control as per our requirements. And to do so, we would need to create a customization for controls. So let's move on to the basics. In this slide, you can see a custom control layer graphic. Starting at the bottom level, you have the system under test, or SUT. In the SUT, you have what the computer understands, so different HTML tags, different classes, XML tags, etc. Here we can see an example of a system under test. This is the Tricentis obstacle website page. Here we can see this control, which is using HTML technology. And at the very top is the representation layer. The representation layer is what the specialist sees to steer the system inside of Tosca. The specialist sees tables, combo boxes, buttons, edit boxes, etc. All of this is human interpretation of what is on the screen. In this same obstacle example, you can see the combo box control. This is the actual view of the control on the UI, which shows the representation. In between the two layers, representation and SUT, is how we get from what the computer understands to what the human sees. One step up from the SUT is the technical layer. The technical layer turns each HTML tag or class into its own C# class. These C# classes are representative of what the computer has and understands. In the slide, we have a couple of examples. There's a HTML table technical, HTML row technical, and a HTML cell technical. These represent the table tag, the row tag, and the cell tag inside of the HTML respectively. If I inspect the application, here I can see the DOM structure, which shows the tag and the properties of the controls. One layer up is the adapter layer. The adapter layer takes the technicals and wraps them up in something that can be interactive. The functions that you can interact with are, for example, putting information into a cell in a specific row, or putting information into all rows of this table. This adapter allows us to go from the representation layer to interact with the technical layer. So it can be seen as being a bridge between the technical and representation layer. In this same application, if we want to customize this div tag, which is our technical as a combo box, we need the adapter, which is the iComboBox adapter. For every control, we have a specific adapter. For example, for buttons, we have the iPushButton adapter. For text boxes, we have the iTextBox adapter. And for links, we have the iLink adapter. And that concludes our exploration of the custom control layers. Thank you for watching.